some of the problems that we face. So we've identified, made a documentary investigation, a compound discarded in the 1980s, which has a selective thermodynamic activity. And this compound, through some preclinical studies that we've conducted that I'll describe in brief, has been now in three phase patient trials. And so far we know that the compound is well tolerated, as no proof seen, which is what trials are facing in these preclinical trials. So we're going forward. Characterization. Many cancer drug development projects undergo. So we use a xenograft model, which is to say we take cancer cells, we put them in a mouse, and we give the mouse a compound, in this case this API-101 compound, and this increase in the amount of the xenograft isn't astounding, but it is at least a clue that we have something that might have some benefit. We made the xenograft again. And very importantly, and here's the critical aspect of trying to decide on which kind of compound we improve with, the patients that are treated for this disease are quite sick, given that it is a late diagnosis of COVID at a late stage, and therefore we have to choose a compound which has no adverse effects. This is not true, of course, for the majority of chemotherapies, which are essentially toxins, which use a cytotoxic, cytokine toxicity level. But this compound was chosen selectively because it is so well tolerated. Here's the compound represented by the body weight of the mouse that is not decreasing. And the compound can also be well effective in this case, looking at the same kind of xenograft assay. When we're starting administration early, this is not really a transport with different specificities. We could somewhat mimic, though we don't quite reach the efficiency of this compound, in the project. A drug development program requires participation of people of a variety of different interests from expertise in drug development, which is not me. And again, the clinical files are run by a startup company. We found that we need assistance from many clinicians, which is something which, again, complements my expertise and has been essential for the project. So I thank you all for your attention and have less questions.
So I'm sort of lost over.